A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Then the just will rise up filled with confidence to face those who had oppressed them and mocked them in their suffering. The sight of the just will make them cower in fear, amazed at the unexpected way God had saved the upright. Filled with regret, they will say to each other, groaning and gasping for breath, "Weren't these the people we made the butt of our jokes and the target of our ridicule? What fools we were to have thought them crazy for the way they lived and dishonored for the way they died. Who would have thought they would be counted among the children of God and assigned a special place among the holy ones?" The desires of the godless are like dust in the wind, like a fine mist carried away by the squall, like a puff of smoke which the wind blows away, passing like the memory of a nomad who made camp only for a night, then traveled on. But the just will live forever, and their reward is with Yahweh, for the Holy One will take care of them. From God's own hand, they'll receive the crown of glory and the diadem of beauty. They'll be protected by God's right hand and shielded with God's right arm. Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. A reading from the Book of Revelation. Then I saw new heavens and a new earth. The former heavens and the former earth had passed away, and the sea existed no longer. I also saw a new Jerusalem, the holy city, coming down out of heaven from God, beautiful as a bride and groom on their wedding day. And I heard a loud voice calling from the throne, "Look, God's tabernacle is among humankind. God will live with them. They will be God's people, and God will be fully present among them. The Most High will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death, mourning, crying, and pain will be no more, for the old order has fallen. I saw no temple in the city, for God Almighty and the Lamb were themselves the temple. There was no sun or moon. God's glory was its light, and the Lamb was its lamp. The nations will walk by the city's light, and the rulers of the earth will bring their treasures. The city's gates will never be shut by day, and there will be no night there. The glory and honor of the nations will be brought into it, but nothing unclean will ever enter it, nor will anyone who does loathsome things or tells lies. Only those whose names are written in the book of life of the Lamb will enter. The angel then showed me the river of life-giving water, clear as crystal, which issued from the throne of God and of the Lamb, and flowed down the middle of the streets. On either side of the river grew the trees of life, which produce fruit 12 times a year, once each month. Their leaves serve as medicine to heal the nations. There will no longer be any curse. The throne of the Almighty and of the Lamb will be there, and God's subjects will serve faithfully. They will see the Most High face to face and bear God's name on their foreheads. Night will be no more. They will need no night light from lamps or the sun, for our God will give them light, and they will reign forever." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty God, who did send your Holy Spirit to be the life and light of the Church, open our hearts to the riches of your grace, that we may bring forth the fruit of the Spirit in love and joy and peace, through Christ our Lord. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that with you, we, being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. O Lord, our governor, whose glory is in all the world, we commend this nation to your merciful care, that being guided by your providence, we may dwell secure in your peace. Grant to the President of the United States, the governor of this Commonwealth, and to all in authority, wisdom and strength to know and do your will. Fill them with the love of truth and righteousness, and make them ever mindful of their calling to serve this people in your fear, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, to whom we must account for all our powers and privileges, guide the people of the United States in the election of officials and representatives, that by faithful administration and wise laws, the rights of all may be protected and our nation be enabled to fulfill your purposes, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and most merciful God, we remember before you all poor and neglected persons whom it would be easy for us to forget, the homeless and the destitute, the old and the sick, and all who have none to care for them. Help us to heal those who are broken in body or spirit, and to turn their sorrow into joy. Grant this, Creator, for the love of your Son, who for our sake became poor, Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Let us now remember before God all the faithful departed dear to our hearts. Georg and Cecilia Lesty, Anne Poole, Amos Poole, Hulda Poole, Edith and Sam Poole, Patsy Poole, John Bagby, Janice Freeman, John and Fran Scott, Kathy Hurst, Susanna Miller, Norman Moore, Anton E. Bernat, Helen W. Bernat, Donald C. Bernat, Sheldon Davis, Paulette Schiff Priest, R. Russell Wright, Helen M. Wright, D. Eleanor Wright, Janet W. Robeland, David Stevens, Dorothy Stevens, C.J. Moore, Helen and Charles Adelman, Catherine and Charles J. Adelman, Catherine J. Adelman, Henrietta and David Johnson, Marguerite and Hervey Hall, Louise and Wallace Krawczyk, May Louise Aldrin, Florence and Richard Johnson, Douglas Johnson, George Johnson, Hendrika Hyland, Skip Sorrell, George Braun, Joanne McBrien, Pamela Kendall McMichael, Franny Smiley, Ann Wilkerson, Jim Trimble Priest, Linda Cloud Weber, Einar Jensen, Emily Lukens, Peggy Anderson, Walt Smith, Sally Colburn Tilbury, Hugh Kelleher Kelly Wood, John E. Mock, Jan Hogan, Bill Witherup, Ahmaud Aubrey, George Floyd, Nick Hedges, K. Kelly Gissendunner, Brianna Taylor, Jeanette and Philip Asden, Annette and Sandy DeWitt, Ted and Floss Willis, Dorothy and Bill Coombs, Edward Jeffries Jr., Henry S. Ely, Eugenia Hun, Gerald A. Haney, Joetha Langley, Sterling Smith, Sylvia Williams, Emma Murray Kelly, John Gerald Murray, Jim Kelly, Michael Murray, Olga Larkin, Edwin Larkin, Bob Anderson, Walter Wallace, Ron Nevin Priest. And all those who died suddenly and unprepared in wars, acts of terror, famine, or natural disaster. We pray that, encouraged by the examples of these your saints and servants, aided by their prayers, and strengthened by their fellowship, we also may be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, through the merits of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant to your saints, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May the souls of all the departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.